What a good message that was delivered this morning at Sunday school. Lifestyle of forgiveness. And forgive me if I have to do praise and worship in English, but may the Holy Spirit overflow this place and may the Holy Spirit speak to your heart this morning. Amen. And before we sing our first song, I just want to talk about this man. So I pray to God to bless me with a message to speak to you this morning. I don't want to preach to you, I just want to share something with you. But God gave me this message, and it must be going, you know, it's happening all over the world, but personally I just feel like I just need to talk about it. And I've been reading the book of Lamentations, Awega, and I've never heard about that book before, but for some reason God has blessed me with that book. And it talks about how a man, how he had suffered. He had suffered from misery, he had suffered from darkness. God led him into darkness. And all these things that Jeremiah, oh yeah, the man is Jeremiah, and all these things that Jeremiah suffered from, it was all God's plan. God had planned for Jeremiah to suffer. God had led Jeremiah into darkness, betrayed his prayers, destroyed him, crushed him into dirt, made him a joke. People were mocking him. And the reason why I want to share this message with you guys is because it's relevant to us today. Because we go through struggles. We go through struggles with money, judgment, all those things, darkness, depression. It says in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, "For I know the plans that I have for you. I have good plans for you. I plan not to hurt you, but I plan for a good future and hope." So when you go through struggles or when you go through darkness, don't give up on hope, because that's what Jeremiah did, and that's the only thing that went through his head when God had crushed him.